Here we have another game brought to us by Sumo Digital, the racing pioneers. Snake Pass. This is something very different than the norm. Almost sounds like a rare game, but it's not. Something from back in the day. So, I haven't really done too much with this yet. Just explore my controls, change my settings. Which for some reason, I've had trouble getting the video changes to stick. Make the recording easier, but I think we got it going now, so let's hop right to it. Moldor's Realm, Paradise Path, okay. So, for anyone who doesn't know about this game, I'm just going to keep it simple and sweet. This is basically a snake simulator. Think of it like that. Ever wonder what it's like to be one of the low-level, slippery, slithery ones? Well, this game is our opportunity to find out. I wasn't expecting dialogue for some reason. Don't know who Noodle is, but yeah, see, this kind of gives me old school Rare vibes, you know, Banjo-Kazooie, Donkey Kong Country. It just has that look to it. Just modern gen. Especially since the animals talk, I wasn't expecting that. Okay. Use to look around, okay. Hopefully this is recording okay. I apologize too for anybody who caught my Hotshots video. It didn't get a lot of views, so probably not too many of you, but I had to take that down. There was a comment who was remarking about how the video was looking so choppy, and I don't know how I missed that. You know, I usually spend a few minutes watching my videos after they've been recorded to make sure they come out okay. I actually watched a couple minutes of that one, but apparently it wasn't enough. Once you get to the actual racing, it all went south, so not looking to do that again. Okay, so it is pretty realistic, despite the look. Oh! Can I fall off the edge? Yeah, might as well see. Yes, I can! For a minute, I thought he was flying. All right, none of that. Hey, A button lifts my head up. Hey. Do the wiggle wiggle, do the wiggle wiggle, do the wiggle wiggle. Okay, that's enough of that. Let's see what else I can do. This sends the camera out. Oh, it sends the camera way out. And this centers the camera. Moves the camera freely. This is the lower analog using the 360 controller as per usual. Right trigger. What helps you move forward. Left trigger. I don't know what that does. Okay, it causes him to open his mouth. Maybe that's to eat or to bite. Doesn't look like a biter though. You know, not all snakes do. Pick up speed by slithering left and right. It looks pretty slow to me. I gotta get a sharp angle on that. Yeah, see, why am I trying to figure out the controls myself when they're just gonna tutorial me as I go? I already figured that move out. I like the way he digests things just like a snake would. That little belly pouch. It's a little tummy. So, leave it to Sumo Digital to come up with something really creative and unique like this. You know, it's always nice to see that they're not just one-trick ponies, because they're really known for their racing games. The excellent drifting and handling mechanics, but you know, this is definitely something outside of the norm. I don't think there's ever been a game that I know of where you get to play as a snake would be. As far as genre, I guess this would pass as a puzzle platform game. Not really action heavy. This might be a nice little game to play when you're just kind of looking to kick back and chill on some downtime. Nothing too strenuous or hectic. Nothing too demanding. Nothing too stressful. Games shouldn't be stressful anyway. That's my opinion. It takes away the purpose of them, but it can get kind of intense depending on what you like to play. I've been kind of hungering for a decent puzzle style game anyway. This might fit the bill. Might scratch that itch. I don't suppose that light does anything. No. This is available on Steam, by the way. Probably on Switch, PS4, Xbox. Not 100%. It'll be in the video description after the video. I'll check on that. Tell me this doesn't make you think of Banjo-Kazooie, though. It's minus the action platform style. I feel like I missed something because I'm running out of things to do, places to go. Oh! Curiosity paid off, apparently. Alright. Okay, apparently I was supposed to go for the stones. Super slithering. Alright. And we can replay stages. Remember, think like a snake. Well, now that I think about it, I don't think I've ever seen a snake in real life. Not including zoos, of course, because that, you know. Somebody said, you don't see the real animal in the zoo. It's like how a lot of times when you see somebody, like on the job or, you know, somewhere out in the public, you're not really seeing the real them. You're just seeing the public persona, the public image, most times. Because there can be some backlash when you're truly yourself in society, unfortunately. A lot of us are scared to be ourselves. Well, animals in the zoo, you know, they're out of their element. And yeah, it's kind of one reason why I stopped going to zoos years ago. The more I started to see it from their perspective, the more I just started to feel really bad. But that's all I'm going to say about that. I don't want to make it sound like I'm guilt tripping anybody who does enjoy zoos. So it's just not my bag. Not my shindig. Not my get down. But I know that there are plenty of snakes in nature and the wild. Places I've lived. I've been in a few places. Never seen snakes though, not even little gardener snakes. I don't know what it is. Maybe one day. I'd like to see one in action. They're very interesting animals. Something inherently calm or meditative about them, I think. They're not a threat. I don't think it's by accident that a lot of ancient cultures and societies highly venerated snakes as a species, likened them to wisdom and knowledge. There's got to be a reason for that, right? Because our ancestors, you know, they didn't just do things to do them. There was methods, reasoning behind things. And can I kind of shortcut this? Can I make this? Try. Slither on. Be a snake. Yeah. Nice. See? You gotta be willing to be bold sometimes in life. Determination can pay off. It doesn't always lead to death. Though it often does. But if you ask me, there are worse fates anyway. I ain't scared. So press Y if I need a lift. Maybe we'll test that out. So are you gonna fly me or what? Alright, so we do have a hummingbird helper here. I thought this was just for the sake of the tutorial, but he might be with us for the long haul. But you know what? This isn't very snake-like, so I think I'm gonna have him or her put me down. Right after I get this. Hey, what are What are you doing, man? I thought you had me. Oh, you. All right. Apparently, my hesitation to trust in you was justified. No more lifts, please. We'll just do it the old-fashioned way. It's gonna belly crawl. Yep, I was just going that way, actually. I didn't need you to add. See, you're taking all the fun out now, because I was just thinking, hey, I could probably crawl up that. I could wrap around that, and then here you had to just spell it out. Sapping away my sense of achievement here. I know another reason this is kind of calming me is the music. The music is very, you know, lighthearted, easy going. There we go. Speaking of puzzle games, when I had an Xbox 360, it's been a while, it was an Xbox Live Arcade puzzle game that I really enjoyed. I haven't seen it since, called Zuma, Z-U-M-A, as in Montezuma. I have to find out if that game is available on PC in any form, because if it is, I might want to pick that one up too. I'm not going to show it on the channel probably, but it's just a fun game to play. One of these days, if when I ever get to live streaming, I'll have a puzzle day, showcase a few different ones. And we're moving along now. As long as we avoid falling off the edge of the earth, I think we'll be straight. I think I can manage that too. Ah, what is it now? You want bird. Okay, keystones. Yeah. First time I paid attention, I'm sure they've said that before. So I guess the purpose of the game officially is to collect the keystones to continue traversing the world to find probably your kidnapped friend. I'm guessing that's what happened. Or we'll just say missing friend. Maybe they weren't kidnapped. Maybe they just went wandering. Got lost. Who knows? This gives us an excuse to slither, basically, and that's all it needs to be. I mean, this is definitely a throwback to games of old where the reason was to play the game. Oh, right, we can swim too, can't we? Let me check this out. I saw this in the controls, so this is too shallow, though. There we go, there's the dive down button, I think. Yeah, it's just too shallow, we can't go any deeper. Again, very nice, because snakes can swim. I've seen footage, at least. Since we've already established, I haven't met any. Personally. Never even known anybody with a pet snake, because that's a thing, too. Where I come from, though, people usually don't get that exotic with their pets. See too much outside of a cat or dog, though I did see a ferret at one point way back when I was younger. It's fairly uncommon these days, though, I think, at ferrets. This, for me, harkens back to a time. This is a nice throwback to when games were all about gameplay, not so much story. Nowadays, a lot of games exist mostly to tell their narrative, and there's nothing wrong with that. Me, I like a balance between the two. I like a good story or a good narrative to keep me interested. But don't get it twisted. For me, gameplay will always come first. Coming from the guy who plays so many role-playing games and tactical strategy. But you know, I wasn't known for that when I was younger. I don't think I played what was my first strategy game? It was probably Dragon Force on Saturn, if you want to count that, actually. Which doesn't play like most of the games in the genre, so there you go. Some people probably wouldn't even consider it a strategy game, but I think it is. It's just cut from a different cloth than most. And my first RPGs were in the early 90s. Stuff like Lunar the Silver Star, Final Fantasy VI, Final Fantasy III to us back then. No fall damage is nice. In fact, I don't even think I really have health as far as I can tell. There are no enemies yet that are really a threat or a hassle or a hindrance. It's mostly just you and the environment. It can be your friend or your foe. Right now I'm trying to make nice. Alright, that's the second keystone. We're looking good. I'm actually really enjoying this, but not in a hyperventilating, overhyped, hooked up way. I mean, this isn't a game you play to get hyped, but if you just kind of want to kick back, de-stress, put your back back, kick your feet up, I think this will get the job done. So I think I will definitely be coming back to this game. In my off time, at least. That's if I give myself more time to play games. I really don't lately. But this would be a fun one to come back to, I think. Like he's doing the limbo, the invisible pole. Alright, L trigger is grip. That's what that does, right? I really am a snake here. And look, he's got hops. Look at how he crossed that. Oh, am I stuck? Come on. There you go. I knew you had it in you. Termination. We'll make it work. And I probably got what I need to go on to the next area, but before I do that, let me just collect a little more. I'm kind of having fun. Snake's life. That's the life for me. You know, because in some parts, snakes get a bad rap. And sometimes even uses a disparaging connotation, you know. That dirty snake. No. There's more than one side to the story. I mean, look at this face. Doesn't look like he'd hurt a fly. Or a hummingbird. Or a ladybug. Yeah, if I could, you look like a tasty treat, but no. My snake is probably a vegetarian, actually, or vegan. He kinda... Oh! Did I... Okay, yeah, he's got hops. I love how he just glided smooth over that. Didn't even bat an eye. I was worked up over nothing. Yeah, this is... It also sort of reminds me of the OG Sonic games where the physics really factor in heavily. This is a very physics-driven game, you know, to add to the sense of control. Because again, it really is like a snake simulator. That's maybe what I'm going to call it now. You know, it's almost 20 minutes in. I think that's good for a quick look, test drive. Of all the independent games I've played recently, I think insane. I guess that means I did pretty good, but I didn't get everything this time. But this has been Snake Pass, everybody. Snake Simulator by Sumo Digital. Check it out. Looks really fun to me. If you like what you see, don't stop here. Please stay tuned for more indie games in the future. This has been PDK. Have a wonderful day. Take care of yourselves. And hopefully, I'll see you soon.